Hi everyone, welcome back to Procedural Workflow for LookdevX. This is the second tutorial of the two-part series. In part 1, I showed how to procedurally create the USD stage for this lamp geometry and how to create materials for it in LookdevX. In this video, I'll focus on how to quickly create variations in the look of the lamps. I'll start with creating USD instances so that we have a group of lamps. Then I'll show you how to automate the process of randomly assigning one of a set of surfaces to each lamp. All the files used in this tutorial are included in the description. Without further ado, let's get started. This is where we left off in the previous tutorial. We created two USD stages. The first one is where we created the USD geometry, and the second one, this paper lamp stage, contains a root layer lamp.usd. where we loaded the geometry layer as a sublayer and added another sublayer where we created the materials. In this tutorial, I'm going to first modify the geometry layer by adding USD instancers and create a Primvar attribute as a preparation for assigning various looks in LookdevX. Then in the material layer, I'll use a combination of the USD Primvar reader and the switch node to realize the variations. Don't worry if the word primvar sounds confusing at this point. I'll explain it as I walk through the procedure. First, to modify the geometry layer, let's hide this paper lamp stage and show the stage where we created the geometry layer. In the USD layer editor, let's switch to this stage as well. Let's also turn on the Bifrost graph where we created this stage and go to the Bifrost graph editor. Here are the prims that we created last time. We have this parent prim lamp, which has two children, lamp shade and lamp stem. Here are scattered some points for creating instances for both the lamp shade and the lamp stem. The red dots are for the shade and the yellow ones the stem. I also create a plane in Maya as the ceiling. Now let's create instances of the lampshade first. To create USD instances, we use the node define USD point instancer. Let's rename it instancer lampshade. Here we need to provide the points where we want the instances to be and the prototype of the instance geometry. For the points, I'm going to use my scattered points for the lampshade. And for the prototype, we can just use this lampshade mesh prim that we created earlier. Get and add to stage. Connect the out stage to stage and the point instancer definition to prim definition. Connect the output to the save stage node, and we see the instances. Let's do the same for the stem. Get a define USD point instancer. Rename it instancer lamp stem. Connect the scattered points for the stem to the port points. And the lamp stem mesh prim to the port prototype definitions. Add it to the stage using the add to stage node. And connect the output to the save stage node. Now we have the stems as well. In the outliner, we see that we've added two prims. The instancer of the shade and the instancer of the stem. We can hide the original lamp. And these are the lamps for which we'll create different looks. In the parameters panel of the define USD point instancer node, this create default material is checked by default. Since we'll create our own material for the lamps, let's uncheck it. And uncheck the one for the stem as well. Now we have all the lamps created. To achieve the variations in the look, we need to do some preparations before we edit the material in LookdevX. And now it's time to introduce the attribute Primvar. Primvar is an attribute that's associated with either geometric primitives or per object properties. For example, for an individual mesh, if we set the interpolation to Primvar vertex and provide it with an array of colors, then each color in the array will be associated with one vertex, and the result is a mesh surface with various colors. For USD instances, if we set the interpolation to Primvar varying and provide an array of colors, then each color will be associated with one instance, and the result is a number of instances with different colors. In our case, what we need is an array of random integers to act as IDs for the instances. Each integer will be associated with a specific instance. This means later we can use the switch node in LookdevX to assign the first surface to instances 0, the second surface to instances 1, the third to instances 2, and so on. Now let's see how to create the primvar attribute. To define an attribute, we first get a define USD prim, the same node that we used to create the prims for the lamp. Here we want to add an attribute to an existing prim, so we set the specifier to over. And here we need to provide the path of the prim that we want to modify, which is the lampshade instancer. Here we can right-click at the path, select Create Value node. This creates a node with the string of the path, and we can just connect the string to the port path. To add an attribute, hover your mouse over Attribute Definitions, right-click, under Create Node, select Define USD Attribute. Go to the Parameters panel. Let's set the name of the attribute to Custom ID. Check Custom. Select Int Array as the type. And check Enable Value. Here under Primvars, check Enable Primvar. And set the interpolation to Primvar varying. This allows each value from the array to be associated with a specific instance. Now we need to create an array of random integers for the Primvar value, which will act as the IDs of the instances. To do that, I'm going to get a random value array. The size of the array should be the same as the number of the instances. Instead of manually entering the number, we can use a getPointCount and connect the scattered points to it. That gives us the number of the instances. Let's connect it to size. The output here is an array of floating point numbers ranging from 0 to 1. If we want the lamps to have, say, 4 different looks, we multiply the result with 4. Round to floor, and then convert the numbers to integers. That gives us an array of random integers ranging from 0 to 3. Now we can connect the values to the port value. I'm going to group these into a compound and name it Generate Custom ID. Inside the compound, we can promote this value which we used as a multiplier to one level above. I'm going to rename it Number of Variants. This way you can change the value based on how many different looks you want to create. You can promote and rename ports in LookdevX as well in the same way. Let's add this modified prim definition to the stage using the Add to Stage node. If we select the instancer in the outliner, go to the attribute editor under extra attribute, we'll see that this prim has a primvar attribute custom ID, which is an integer array of 18 numbers. Now we finish the geometry part. Let's save this USD layer. I'm going to override the old lampgeo.usd file that we created in the previous tutorial. Before we move to LookdevX, I want to quickly generate the point lights for the lamps. Here I've created a number of mesh spheres, one at each of the scattered points. I'm going to get an output node, connect the mesh spheres to it. Let's hide the lampshades for a moment. The centers of these mesh spheres will be the locations of the point lights. I'm going to bake them into Maya by right-clicking and selecting Create Maya Mesh. Now I have all of them in Maya. I'm going to group them. Open the script editor. Here I wrote a Python script for generating the point lights based on the center locations of the mesh spheres. Let's run it. Hide the group of the mesh spheres and hide the Bifrost graph. And here we have all the lights. Let's group them and rename it Point Lights. Now we're ready to assign the materials. Let's hide the stage and show the paper lamp stage where we have a root layer with both the geometry and material sublayers. In the USD layer editor, let's switch to the paper lamp stage as well. If the geometry layer hasn't updated automatically, you can remove it, then reload it. And now we have the instances that we just created. Let's hide the individual lamp. On the material sublayer, inside the MTL prim, I've created a new material called Lampshade Instancer MTL, which contains four variants that we'll use for texturing the instances of the lampshade. Let's open it in LookdevX Graph Editor. Right-click and select Show in LookdevX. Go inside this container, and here are the four standard surfaces that I created. The lotus flower with white background, the same lotus flower with pink background, koi fish with blue background, and the same fish with green background. If you want to learn how to create this kind of textures, the details are covered in the previous tutorial. Let's first test if the system works. I'm going to connect one of the surfaces to the output. Go to the lampshade instancer, expand it, under prototype, select lampshade. Right-click, under assign existing material, select lampshade instancer MTL. I'm going to turn on the sky dome light. Set the prototype geometry to double-sided in the attribute editor under geometric prim. And render it. We see that the fish texture is assigned to the instances. To realize the variations, we use a combination of the node switch shader and USD primvar reader. In our case, the custom IDs are integers, so we select this USD primvar reader int. In the parameters panel, enter custom ID for the var name. Connect the result to the port index of the switch node. And then connect surfaces 1, 2, 3, 4 to input 0, 1, 2, 3 respectively. Connect the output to the port Arnold surface of the output node. This way, instances with ID 0 will have the lotus flower with white background. The ones with ID 1 will have the pink background, ID2 will have the fish with blue background, and ID3 the green background. Render it again, and we get the variations. Let's also assign the material of the stem to the stem prototype. That's it for today. To recap, we learned how to procedurally create the USD stage for this lamp geometry, how to create materials for it, and how to quickly create variations in the look of the lamps. Let us know in the comment if you have any questions. Please stay tuned, we'll have more tutorials coming soon. Thanks for watching, I'll see you next time.